Welcome to Trading Lounge and the European indices, and starting with the German mid cap here, because it's got a nice clean count and we're looking for five waves down from B down to C here. So wave one is quite clear, wave two is clear, and then we have one and two in here, and three and four and five for the third wave, the fourth wave here, and then the fifth wave, we're looking for a low here. Now, we know that fourth waves can get rather complicated, so you're going to have to be a little bit patient here until we can pick up a clearer direction here. Obviously, the move up here is trending up over these days. It's obviously at resistance from the old high here, and also this medium level here, the 25,000. So let's just see if this basically lets go of that high and starts to move lower through here. So considering that wave four there and looking at the German DAX here, just on the 4-hour chart, we were looking for it to pull back up to the 38.2% retracement level, which is lower than the wave four of one lesser degree here. So it's actually about here somewhere. So we're kind of in the right space here. The thing here, though, is there's a couple of things we need to talk about. This move up through here hasn't taken out the high here, but on some markets it has. So on the AEX it has, on the French market, the CAC, it has, on the FTSE it hasn't. So there's a variety of things that there's a couple of options here really. So I mean, if this made a new high here, then I would probably need to look at this in five waves up. The other, and we'll look at that in a moment, but the other main point here too is that this particular move here, we can't short it unless the 11,500 is the resistance. So any move down through here is going to cause a a bit of a bounce. So after the bounce, if the market moves through, then allow it to do that and then just wait for the retest here. And then that would be the short signal, one point below that reference point high there. And if it comes down, well, then we'll be short on that side there. So that's the way to sort of handle that. I mean, because this hasn't made a new high here, it appears that it is five waves up here. I've pulled it apart. But otherwise, we'd look at it as an A and a B and a C wave. Here and then a move higher here. So if the price is above the 11,500, which is the medium level here in terms of the trading levels, then we want to really be looking for long trades here and not short trades above the level here. But at the same time, we need to understand where the 50-60% retracement level is from these guys here. So pretty much if the 11,600 becomes the nice tested support, then you can trade long from that point. Okay, so you would need to see that it would move up, it would react, and then it would move up, and then it would have its little correction here, and then it would move up from that point. So really it's about getting it over on this side of the fence here. So there's a fair way to wait here. I mean, I think we just really need to be a little bit cautious here. We're also looking for the S&P to top out as well and pull back. So we need to be really careful in this space here. So I think that the best thing to do is just wait for a session and let's just see what gets delivered. The other point too is that Friday can dictate what Monday is going to do. So a strong closing either with the market moving bullish or market moving bearish is likely to follow through on the Monday. So just remember that. So perhaps look for your trade a little bit later in the in the second session and not the first session, and just allow it to find its direction at that point. So on the 1 hour chart here, it's probably not the case, but in this instance here, from the low here, I can count, this is a bit of a dodgy wave one here and wave two here. That's okay, the wave two. And then we've got five waves up here for wave three. And if I look at this as wave four, And I can look at that as wave five. It does appear to have five waves in it. Like when I look at the AEX, for example, with the same picture here, it's got a nice clear five waves up as one and two and three and four. And it makes a new high here for wave five. Okay, so in this case here, you can go long here, but you'd have to go long higher up here. Otherwise, this market can fall back down into this space here. And this is the same for the CAC as well. If we look at this here, from this low here, we can look at a one and two here, and one and two here, and then the nice third wave and fourth wave and fifth wave for wave three and ABC for wave four. And once again, we kind of make a new high here as well. Okay, so in this case, I've figured that we would, the B wave won't come that high. So if this A wave comes down somewhere and bounces off the 5,100, which would be about right, wouldn't it? And then the B wave back up 50 or 60%, and then wave C moving down. So in this instance here, we can grab that low and this high. I mean, this is, most of the markets are looking like this as such. So, I mean, of course, if this is counted correctively up through here, then we'll be coming much further down. But it's possible in the first instance that the market can pull back into this space here. And this is what we need to be mindful of, okay? So, yeah, I would, if I had to short this, well, then I would wait for this to complete here. I would look at the retest here as such. I'll just keep it simple, draw a line across there. If that's breached, then you'll get the C wave coming down. And not only we get the C wave, if this is wave four up here already, like we've been looking at the other markets, then we're going to be coming down further than that as well, making new lows. So it's kind of worth having a crack here. We can just make it a small amount and build in along the way with that. And the FTSE hasn't made a new high above here. So when we look at that, we can see how sluggish it is. I've just kept the labeling here of an A wave and a B wave and five waves up for a C wave of wave four here. I guess we could, I mean, I've been looking at this as an ABC pattern here, but we could possibly get one and two and three here, ABC for four and down for five here. So it's possible this way, but this, I mean, I'm looking at this and I can count five waves up here. So I'm a little bit lost on this one here as well. But because we're above 7,000 here, because we're above the closest largest number, we need to be looking at buying new highs, but not selling new lows at this stage. So if this market, from this low here to this high here, it does appear that I can count five waves here, and it should pull back into the 7,100 or the group two just below it at 80, 72 and 65. But if this becomes, if this 61.8 becomes the retested resistance, well, then you know that we will be coming further down from that point as such. So, yeah, just, but at the same time too, if we're going to make new highs, then look to trade long above that scenario. Now, so it's really about tactics, but I think that waiting for the first session to unfold would be the right thing to do. Just don't have a clear pathway. And for the MIB here, we're counting five waves up, which we've done in terms of one and two. And it's a little bit tricky within here, but this could be wave three over here, but still leave wave four here. And then up for wave five here for wave A, and we're looking for wave B to pull back. It didn't pull back as far as I wanted it to. And then looking for wave C to move up. So, yeah, I mean, perhaps I can count all of this in five waves to the upside as well. But the main point here that I can see is that this move down through here appears to be in five waves. So I'm thinking that that we get a bit of a rally and then we come down again as well. So once that low is in place here and we get that rally, if it's in three waves, And then takes out this low here again, or see if an ABC here and draw a line through it, then you can look to short this one here as well. We have met our target here. This box here, by the way, was our target to the upside. And of course, I wouldn't turn bullish on this market unless we had the 20,000 as the support. This is really just the retest of the 20,000. So that's what markets do. If that's if we consider this the 20,000 here, the market would come down, have a bounce off it, come through it, and then come back and retest it. And in that retest, that's sort of where we are now. So we can look for failure here. And in terms of failure, we do have that first little five waves here. So once that's in play, it would make sense to look for a short trade here. But keep it small, very small, and we can look to add under 19 if that's going to be the case as well. So, look... Apologies, I just can't figure out the structure to the upside. It's not totally clear. So you're going to have to be, get your indicators out, see if things are overbought in your time frame, and look for the trading levels of support or resistance, and keep the trading to a minimum until we've got a clear pathway for the euro indices. Alrighty, cheers.